welcome to this balance sheet restructuring analysis of Kenya Airways. In particular, we'll be looking at the share dilution portion of it. The document itself is called Project Safari and it's 41 pages long. It's a bit opaque, so this is to illustrate some of the things that might not be too clear. So let's say you invest in 1,000 shares at 5 shillings per share, meaning that you put 5,000 shillings. Now, pre the restructuring, your share is split 1 into 20. So you'll have 20,000 shares at 25 cents each, meaning that you'll have 1,000 interim shares and 19,000 deferred shares. Now, I know you are curious to know what deferred shares are. Now, deferred shares are a certain type of share which the normal voting rights that you get are missing, and also the economic value that you get from a share in terms of dividend and capital gains are also not there. So what they'll do to these 19,000 deferred shares is basically retire them, which is equivalent to flushing them down the toilet. So they'll no longer exist and you'll be left with 1,000 shares of 25 cents each. Now, since they don't want the price to trade at upper value less than 1 shilling, they'll consolidate 4 into 1. So you'll be left with 250 shares of 1 shilling each. And now, finally, from your initial investment of 5,000 shillings, you'll be left with 250 shillings. Now, that translates to a 95% dilution, both in the market value and in the par value of the share. So my final thoughts are, this balance sheet restructuring has been done at a very high cost to the minority investor, that is you, me, excluding government and the banks. And already they have spent more than 1 billion, and the management is yet to show measures that will give KQ a lasting competitive advantage, meaning that the landscape hasn't changed.